One of the most exciting and ambitious 360 cameras ever designed is the Kandao Qoocam. I got to shoot with it at IVRPA 2018. Find out why it may become the best consumer 360 camera for 2018. Hi, my name is Mick and you're watching 360 Rumors, the resource that 360 shooters trust for in-depth camera reviews and innovative techniques.
Hey guys, we're here at Verpa and we're here to talk to Kandao about the new Qoocam. Yeah. So you saw me talk about it at CES with their VP Grace, but now here we have the actual unit and we're going to try it out. Let's see how to use it. So yeah. This is Ivy.
Hi everyone.
Hi. So Ivy, can you tell us more about the Qoocam for those who don't know about it?
Oh yes, Qoocam is a quite unique camera and it got three lenses. And the most interesting is it can not only do 360, but also can twist like this and record the front in 180 3D.
Yes, right.
VR 180 and 360 together in one camera.
So, like in this mode, it's going to be 360, right?
Yes.
And then in this mode, it becomes VR 180 on this side.
Yes.
That's right. So, what else is interesting? Can you tell us about the depth mapping capabilities? That's one of the unique features of the Qoocam.
Yes. So, yes. As we built the professional camera Obsidian, and it's can output depth map, and we bring that technology into this small little camera. Mm-hmm. And when you do the 180 degree in 3D, and we can, it can also output depth map. Mm-hmm.
So, like the depth map means that not only can you see the picture in 3D, but the viewer can understand like how far or how near something is.
Yes.
So what are some of the things that you can do with a depth map?
Yes, the depth, based on the depth map, we can create a virtual effect like the refocusing. Yes, it's mimicking the bokeh effect, and you can tap wherever you want on your app or software, and you can blur the background and enhance the foreground to enhance your objects.
Great,
It's have more possibilities for your post-production.
Yeah, and you can also use the depth map to change the background, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so that's really cool.
Yes, that feature is still under development.
Right.
And the first thing we will offer is the refocusing.
Right, yeah. And it can it do 6 DOF?
Yes. With the depth map, there is a lot of possibilities. And 6 DOF is available for Obsidian, yes, for now, and I think with these two eyes, we can do a small range, but
that's like a huge difference from just like because normally even with a 3D 360 camera, but if it doesn't have a depth map, if you move around, the whole world moves, so it's not immersive. But with this one, you, at least if you move a little bit, it will look like you could see behind a little bit, up or down. Yeah.
Yes, yes. The surrounding will change according to your maybe a slightly movement.
Yes.
Yes.
All right. So I'm super excited now. So tell me how to use it. Can you show me? Like, is this working? Like, this one?
Yes. This one is working.
All right. So let's try the 360 mode first. So I do that. Yeah. So how do we turn it on?
Here is a power button here.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, the shutter is the power button?
Yes, the power
button. I see. Okay.
You press.
All right.
Okay.
Oh, so I just heard the tone.
Yes.
Okay.
And you press twice, and there is the Wi-Fi signal. Wi-Fi signal light here.
Okay. So the front, you press the button to activate the Wi-Fi?
Yes. Yes.
So tap it twice to activate the Wi-Fi.
Yes.
And tap it twice to turn it off.
Okay.
Right. Okay. There you go.
Yes, and we got our own app on the cell phone, and we can connect remotely. Okay. Yes, with the Qoocam.
All right. So, and it uses. Does it use Bluetooth or Wi-Fi?
Bluetooth and Wi-Fi.
Oh, both.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
What's the advantage of having both?
Yes, with Wi-Fi, you can remotely preview what you are going to film. Uh-huh. And with Bluetooth, you can maybe you use a self-stick, and you can just press the button, and the camera will be remotely controlled.
Okay, yeah. You mean you can use any generic Bluetooth controller? Like if I buy a selfie stick that with a Bluetooth controller?
Yes, we will firstly provide our own.
Okay.
And maybe... Yes, in the later.
Cool. Yeah.
Yes, here is the preview.
Oh, you get the live preview.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah.
Take a look at that. So this is the 360 mode now.
Yeah.
Can we start a recording?
Of course.
Yeah. So by the way, the video is going to be 3840 by 1920 at 30 FPS.
Yeah.
And one thing. Is it stabilized? Can you move it? Like, is it going to be stabilized in real time?
No. This is only the preview.
I see.
Only the preview.
But
the stabilizer is stabilization is only in the post production.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, cool. Okay. But you can do that. It's okay, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. All right. So, how do you take a photo? Oh,
yes.
So she just switched modes to
switch mode.
Yeah, to the at the bottom you can switch here. So there's the photo mode, there's the video mode. Okay, and so we go photo mode. Is it recording?
Yes.
Sorry.
Okay, he just take a picture.
Okay. All right. So now.
Yes. Let's take a picture.
All right.
1, 2, 3. Yay!
All right.
You hear the sound?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then. Is it going to be, does it show you the live preview, I mean the preview of the shot right now?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Cool.
Yes, and there is a very convenient function of our app is that it will follow automatically with the structure of the camera. So if I turn the camera to this position,
it immediately understands if you're switching modes.
Yes.
Oh, so you switch modes by switching the, by switching the camera. I think I just pressed the power button, or is that the shutter?
It's just the Wi-Fi button.
I see. Okay. So if you switch it like this, you don't switch with the app. You switch by turning the camera.
The app will change accordingly.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. So can you show us the 3D 180 mode?
Yes.
Now that we're in 3D 180 mode?
Yes, 3D 180 mode.
Right.
And the operation is similar with the 360 one.
Okay.
Yes, yes, and you can take pictures.
Can I, let's say this one.
So okay.
This is going to be like a selfie, 3D selfie.
Yes,
okay.
You're right.
All right, so that was a 3D 180 photo?
Yes.
Okay, so...
I will try to do some refocusing effects. For our selfie, yes.
Wow, okay. So let's check that out. Ivy's going to send that to us. Now, this 3D 180, is it compatible with VR 180? The Google VR 180?
Yes, we will follow the format of VR 180. And we hope that the users that can automatically upload the video to YouTube to experience this kind of format.
All right, that's really cool.
There are many things I like with the Qoocam's video quality. The detail is quite good. The colors are natural looking. Dynamic range looks excellent. Stabilization looks very good. There's a little bit of waviness at the stitch line, but to me it's unobtrusive. I also like that it has the option to shoot at 60 FPS. As for VR 180, I've been shooting with it for a month with a Lenovo Mirage, and I really like the format. Watch out for my upcoming review of the Mirage. But the short answer is that the VR 180 option for Qoocam is very useful.
So when will it be available and how much?
So now it's on Kickstarter, only I think 1 or 2 days left.
Yes. Yeah, there's only 1 or 2 days left, God. But after the 2 days, then what happens?
Yes, we will go to Indiegogo in demand. Okay, for 1 month.
Okay.
And we will deliver the products in August.
Oh, okay. Yes. That's really soon.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's really exciting. Yeah. All right.
Hope you like it.
Yeah. So thanks very much, Ivy.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.